Like, you know, it'd be crazy if you was in college right now. And I was like, you know, that's crazy. He said, so let's do it. And I'm like, okay, yeah, let's do it. So he kind of showed me the process and we got started. And since then, at 14, I graduated with 2 associate's degrees on the same day. And I could tell you that day was insane.
The same day?
The same day. And that's when, at 15, I graduated again, making history at Langston University.
Langston University.
Langston University.
I know a little something about that.
Langston University. I graduated with my bachelor's, and now I'm 16, a third grade teacher, the youngest teacher in the United States. And working on my master's of business and administration and marketing. So I will finish my MBA in the spring and I'll make history again at 16 years old.
Yo, what's up, everybody? Listen, I'm excited. First of all, happy Black History Month to everybody that's watching. Today we have Black History on this, and I'm so excited to have this wonderful young woman here. If you watched this, she was on Jennifer Hudson. And you know part of her story. She was all over the news. But today she is right here on Unmuted to share her story and to share her Black history with your boy Simp7, okay? So I want you guys to welcome and to honor the youngest teacher in America. The youngest teacher, Miss Shania Muhammad. How are you doing, my sister?
Listen, I'm doing good. I'm doing good. I'm blessed. So I'm happy.
Hey, I'm happy to have you on, man. Thank you for being free enough to do this, you know.
Of course.
Because you out there getting college degrees and Nobel Peace Prizes and stuff like that. You just doing a daggone thing, you know?
I got you.
Yeah. So how do you feel knowing that you are the youngest teacher in America?
Man, it honestly feels so surreal because I didn't really know until it was brought up as a joke. After I got my job, like after it was like official and I was already in class, it was like, man, you know, it'd be funny to be youngest teacher in America. So I mentioned it and I was like, hold on, let me figure out if I am. So when I figured out I was, I said, oh my God. So yeah. Literally I looked up, I said, who's the youngest teacher in America? Google already had me on there. It's my name. I said, oh my God.
Yeah.
They did the work for me. So
yeah.
I was surprised. I said, wow. And like since then, since I posted it, it just went crazy. And I was like, oh my
That's
God.
Amazing. Man, before we even go into further, man, I just want to say from Unmuted to you, listen, thank you so much for being an example for young people.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for not being like Sexy Red.
Listen. I know we gotta cancel those and get some conscious people.
Man, because I mean, you know, coming up in my day, you had the Brainiacs, but they was, you know, of the white descent, and they was on, you know, a new Inside Edition, Oprah, but they never was around us. You know what I'm saying? So it's just a blessing to see that you're so positive and you're out there and you're doing it, man. It's just so amazing to see this, man. So thank you for coming on this stage.
Absolutely.
In my little town, you know what I'm saying, Unmuted to come do this. So, All right. So let's get into it. What was your childhood like? Because to have the type of discipline that you have kind of takes away from a childhood of playing with Barbie dolls and video games and all. What was that like?
Honestly, let's see. Honestly, education has always been the foundation of our home growing up with me and my siblings. There's 5 of us. So like we were all really, really intelligent, really, really smart. And I'm second to the youngest. So like I got to see my older siblings do everything throughout academics, scoring high on tests, you know, graduating early and so what. And so growing up, I don't know, we still had fun. It's just there was like a requirement for that. So it's like, hey, if you want to go outside, go ahead, write your book report. you know, go ahead, get your 30 minutes of reading done. Black history books was big and major in our home. We didn't even read fiction books. It was strictly black history and self-help books that help you understand the mind. Like, it was funny when I tell people I read Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill when I was 9. And people was like, you was already on it. And I was like, now think about it again. So I'm rereading it again. I'm like, I remember reading this when I was 9, but that was just like the foundation in our home. That was what we were so used to and accommodated to. So like, I still had an amazing childhood. Every summer we would get summer passes to like all the swimming pool places, to amusement parks. So like, and there was 5 of us, so we was always lit. You know, my brother's right. The DJ, so he...
Okay.
Yeah, we was turned all the time. Like, he'll always set up in the living room, and we would have our own little parties, invite all the family over. And so it was still really, really fun. It was just, we knew we got to work hard to play hard. And that was established so young. So I still kicked it, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, your all girl right. still had her fun. It was just, I knew I had to get some things done before then.
Okay, you guys see how dope she is. So this is what I want y'all to do. To like, comment, and share. Hit that notification bell because you don't want to miss her. Forget me. It's all about her today, y'all. You don't want to miss it. So hit that like, comment, and share button. Make sure you tune in down there in the comments and just go ahead and ask y'all questions and stuff because it's going to be amazing. It's going to be amazing, y'all, because y'all kids get on my nerves at school. So I want them to turn out to be like her. That's why I'm hard as I am, all right? So do that. Like, comment, share, y'all. So my next question to you is, this is Black History Month, and a lot of things, especially here in Florida, you know, we got a goofy governor that cut out Black History and stuff like that, whatever, yep. We still going to do it anyway. Absolutely. But before he done that, Black History was kind of boring to our kids because they hear the same thing over and over. You, as an African-American teacher, regardless of what age you are, how do you make it fun for your students to learn about our history?
I make it relevant and modern. So one thing that I realized, I had like amazing teachers who taught Black history in a very creative way. So we always know, like, during school, you most likely gonna have your Black history play where you either doing a little poem or you're playing a character. And that's fun, but we're too often focused on, I understand Black history is supposed to be back then, but there is something called modern Black history. I teach my kids about people that are still alive, you know,
right,
people that
exactly.
they can. I done pulled people from, you know, on a Zoom call. I want you to come speak to my kids because there's walking Black history. We're still alive. We're still doing the darn thing. You feel what I'm saying?
Exactly. So, yes, like, yes.
Whenever I am teaching, I am not saying back in the 1800s. Whenever I ask my students, what does Black history look like to you? They said slavery. I didn't even hear civil rights activists. I didn't hear no more. They slaves. That was the most common thing. If our students are only thinking of slavery, a very depressing time, a very hard, crucial time for Black history, no one wants to learn about that. You feel what I'm saying? Like,
right,
of course, it's important to know, but no one wants to just sit there and learn about it. So you gotta change the perspective. So like my homegirl, she 15 and graduated with her bachelor's. You feel what I'm saying? And
yeah.
I was like, hey, sis, come talk to the class. I got another
right.
homeboy. He's right. like the youngest engineer. I got another one that's the youngest lawyer. We are all making history, but it got to be relevant to what we're doing today.
Relevant to what we're doing today. Exactly.
Yes. That's the main point. So that's how I make it fun.
Because yes. I went to school in the 90s. You know what I'm saying? I'm 39. Went to school in the 90s. Grew up in last part of the 80s and all. And we learned about slavery, learned about the civil rights, but it was so depressing. As you said, it was scary, but it was good to know. It was
very good to know.
But we learned in slave songs, Papa gonna kill that chicken. Ain't
right.
that good news? Hey, man, y'all put on some Tupac.
Tupac? That's what I'm saying. Like, the vibe ain't vibing. You know,
the kids
looking left and right like, this is what this Black history about this
right.
about.
Right, exactly. But if they're not also hands-on with it, then they really won't understand. You know, I went to Tuskegee University, took a visit there. My family live over in Alabama, so I went there, and it was just so awesome to see George Washington Carver's artifacts there, everything that he did
right.
with the color blue. People don't even understand where blue come from. George Washington
right.
Carver. You
right.
know, all that stuff, to be hands-on with it, that would be amazing for our kids as well. But, you know. So that's so cool. But,
okay.
yeah. So I found out a little bit about you, and in the COVID year, as we live nowadays, like COVID never existed, but it did.
Right.
You took the time out to go to college. Tell me about that. Tell me about
it. Listen, let me tell you, COVID year was a curse and a blessing. No one liked to be at home. No one liked to just sit at the crib. But education expanded because we had to move to online. Kids still had to learn. You still had to get education in the community. So colleges opened up a lot of their programs for free. A lot of people didn't know that. So dual enrollment was tuition free. The only thing you were paying for was fees. So whenever we were figuring these things out, there was no ACT scores because in order to take the ACT, you had to be in a certain place to do it. No one could go anywhere. So they removed ACT score requirements, removed GPA requirements, and just said, hey, come apply. No one knew it. So there was like a couple of colleges that did it. And I believe it was hundreds of them that did it. But so whenever I figured that out, I was like, you know, because there's one thing, getting your education, that's when it being debt free.
Pause. Bookmark. Pause, flag on the plate. I got to ask you this. So since they took away all that, what was your grades like before you did that?
My grades, mind you, I was homeschooled. So I had the ACT score to get a full ride. So my business was taken care of. It was a great opportunity for anyone that was struggling. And then in their mind, they didn't think they could get into college. Okay. I was like, 2020 was your year. You done missed out.
Yeah.
You know? But no, my grades personally was taken care of.
Oh, okay. All right. Great.
Absolutely. That's kind of, I took advantage of that. So that's when I started homeschooling. And people think with homeschool, you just tell people whatever grade you want your child to be in. It don't work like that. There's, of course, standards. So once we learned them and like understanding the system for homeschooling in our state, that's whenever we figured out, you can do this as young as you can, as long as you can like show that you know the material. Right. So a lot of people put me in testing. I start passing all the tests, but that's because my focus was the ACT. I strictly focused on the ACT for curriculum. So it like really expanded my reach on understanding high school material. And that's when going into college. And so mind you, with that gap being no ACT score, no GPA, just apply, write this essay, and you get in, plus it's tuition free. I mean, why not?
Right. Wow. Okay. So was the testing hard? Was the classes hard? Did you, feel like, man, I don't want to do it no more, man.
I had my days. So the first two classes was not hard. I took English Comp 1, U.S. Government. So I've been writing since I was like 7. And so when I was in 5th, 6th grade, my teachers told my parents, hey, she could write on a collegiate level. So writing's always been my strong suit. So I never had a problem there. And that's like 80% of college anyways, writing these papers.
Right.
And that's when, with everything else, it was online. So it wasn't that difficult. Whatever I didn't know, I looked it up on YouTube, learned it in 20 minutes. And that's when I applied it. I mean, it really wasn't too much hard of a process, but I most definitely had my days where I ran this like chemistry. I love chemistry, but chemistry did not love me back. And I said, I don't know how I feel about this one-sided relationship.
Right.
So, no, being chemistry, most definitely got to a few arguments here and there, but we figured it out.
Okay. All right, cool. Yeah. You figured it out. And obviously you did.
I did.
How many degrees you have?
I have 3.
Good grief, man. Yo, you got some people my age still working on 1. But they getting up, but my God, and you're 16.
Yes.
But you started this when you was 15?
13.
Oh my God. Wow.
That's when I took my first college course.
So, hey, anybody watching this, hey, look, you're never too young, obviously. You're never too young. You have dreams and goals that you want to reach. Please take the first step. Just try. Yeah. Just try. Obviously, we got evidence of it right here. And I'm just so, that's crazy. 13 years old. Man, you know what I was doing when I was 13? Man, I was watching Ninja Turtles.
I was just waking up, taking care of business. And that's when I'll go watch TV.
You did this all during COVID, man. I was making songs, with the Voicy app that came out. I was doing music with that.
I do.
Hey, Leon, can you show that little clip of me making music? There's nobody here named Leon. I'm just saying it so people can think I got a whole studio crew here. I don't. Gotcha. Just me.
But anyway, I'm like, I was waiting for Leon.
I'm locked up in my room because they heard me coughing. Trying to stay alive so I won't be coughing. Jesus dropping signs and they coming often. But I want you to know I don't have corona. I don't have corona. I don't have corona. Hey, hey, yeah. I don't have corona. I don't have corona. I don't have corona. Hey, hey, yeah. Got me in the room talking quarantine. Feeling like a kid talking about my teens. Going outside, it ain't not a thing. Corona, baby. Okay. All right, that's exactly what we did. We was trying to figure out what is life is going to be like through this whole process. The whole world is shut down. Everything has changed. People getting mad at us because we don't have a plan for school. Nobody did.
Right. Nobody
did. You can't get mad at us. We're all in this together. Your job laid you off. We're at home now with masks on, and now we got to come on a computer and teach your kids.
Mm-hmm.
It was tough. So everybody was getting mad. They were saying this, that, and the other, this, that, and the other. Oh, y'all, sorry. It's like, do you not understand that it's 1,000 people dying a minute right now?
Nobody
ever this. We don't know. So, but on the other foot, you on the other hand said, no, I'm going to go to college.
Yeah. I mean, might as well take advantage.
Right. Might as well take advantage. Right. Exactly. So how does it feel to know that you are smarter than your average 25-year-old?
Oh my God. Listen, so many people ask me similar questions. And I don't know. I really, when people meet me, they're like, you don't even know, like, unless you know who I am. They're like, you could tell you're intelligent. A lot of people have seen me out and they was like, do you teach? They wouldn't even know my story. People just say I look like a teacher.
Right.
And it's so funny because I have such a, I guess I, people say like a humbled approach, but it is pretty cool being smart, like understanding complex concepts. Like, I don't know why people think we just nerds and introverted. Like I said, I kicks it, but it's really cool being smart and understanding things. It makes life a lot easier.
Right. Hey, I see that. I see that for you. So at work, do people like try to throw shade? Like, think she all that 16 and they kind of like jealous?
Yeah. I mean, listen, a few have, but my workplace is really, it's really strong. I since like I'm the baby of the building. That means ain't nobody bothering me. I mean, I've had adversity and conflict with certain parents. They ain't get too far because my coworkers don't play about me.
Right.
So I got a lot of support. My boss, the principal, the owner of the school, she don't play at all. She like, who said who and a what about Miss Muhammad?
So I'll
be like, y'all got to calm down. This is a place of work.
And I'm going to say this. Like I said, I've been watching from afar. You got your dad and all like daddy bald head. I know bald head Muhammad's don't play. I know that. But I'm going to tell you this right now. And I mean what I say. You got your 39-year-old uncle down here in Florida. Don't play about his. So you hit me up a DM or hit me up on the celly. I make sure you ain't nobody bothering you. That's real.
Listen, it's so I got a great support team, but I most definitely had a few that, you know, have you with the, oh, she thinks she all that. And I do. I mean, why not?
Yeah, that's right. That's what I like to hear. I do. I put in the work. I got my degrees. Now I'm here.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I do think I'm all that. That's right. It's a humble way to think. You know what I'm saying? But it's not big headed. But I do think I'm all that. Yeah, that's right. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, Shania. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. That's cool. All right. So now, you know, I did a session a few days ago and I was telling the kids, you know, when we was growing up, we wanted to grow up fast. But our parents told us, man, once you get those bills, you know, but now you got a full-time job. You're 16. You got responsibility now. You're in a tax bracket now. How does it feel to have a full-time job and now you paying bills?
Man, me and bills don't go together. I don't like them. And I tell people all the day, like so many people, they be like, oh, so do you think you're grown? I don't. Grown comes with bills right behind them. So right. I'm going to stay 16 as long as I can.
As long as you can. That's right. That's right.
And so, yeah, I never push. I'm trying to be grown and grown perspective. But, yes, the bills is real. And I don't like them. But, I mean, I feel like it's preparing me for life. So, like, I'm training 2 years before I really get out in the world and actually have to start paying real people bills, living on my own, and all that. So I understand the concept of money now and understanding financial literacy. So like savings, investings, and all that, I'm able to start that down.
Credit, all that. Yeah.
With the money that I am making. So it's really honestly a blessing to get started since I'm already accumulating it. And I'll be prepared when I'm 18. So I won't go out in the world like,
exactly.
What is taxes? How that work?
Right, exactly. Mm-hmm. So with that, are you getting paid the average salary for a teacher, like the real salary? Or they just saying, well, okay, well, you're 16, or you're young, we're gonna kind of like back off a little bit.
Oh no, I actually get paid more than people think with teaching because I got 3 degrees. So and since I'm working on my master's, it knocks me up a notch. So a lot of people believe since I was 16,
so dope, man. You make it bread,
bro. I said, nah. I get paid. You feel what I'm saying?
Oh, man. That's what I'm talking about. Money being made around here. Bang. Money being made around here. Bang. Big old cars. Rain, rubber. Diamonds and rings. If you like that kind of thing, money being made around here. Woo! Money being made around here. That's good. Yeah. So dealing with that, now you're getting paid. You got your bread and you're making more. How is it saving? Because, I mean, now you are over. You don't need mom and daddy no more. You go wherever you want. Get what you want whenever you want it.
Right.
Is there any restraint on your finances?
No. Honestly, since I was 9, I started making money. And because I was always entrepreneur-minded. And so I was always real smart with my money. I never... Yes. Like, I'm not blowing it, like, how people get their first big check and go to the mall. Yeah, I mean, I'm going to go to the mall. I'm going to spend my coins. But I ain't going to do it recklessly. So, it's like, I don't know. I always kept a great budget in mind. And I don't like wasteful money. I don't like wasting nothing. So, it's like, I'm real tight with it. But I understand if I want something, I'm going to get it because I got it.
Right, exactly.
You know, and anything that leaves my wallet comes back 10 times more. So I tell people all the time, I'm a money magnet. I can make money anytime I want, you know. Right. Money ain't my problem. It's my time. It's like, do I got 4 hours today?
Right, that's so amazing, man. And the way how you carry yourself, you couldn't tell if you were 16 or nothing like that. You're so well-versed. You have an old spirit. My bad. Pause. You don't have an old spirit. You have a middle-aged, I'll say 25 to 36 type of you know what I'm saying? You're good, man. That's awesome. So your background, let's see how can I maneuver this and ask this the right way. Your background. Now you're the young, you're the middle child. You're the middle.
Sec to the youngest. So no, I'm
you said so it's 5 of y'all.
5, yeah.
So you're number
2.
You're number 4. You're number 2.
4. It all depends how you counting. I'm second to the youngest, so there's 5. There's 3. That's me.
Okay, a math equation right there. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you so much. So, so how is it? Now, I don't know about your other brothers and sisters or whatever. Now, you know, are they teachers or anything like that? Are they?
Oh, yeah. My sister's a teacher. My brother, he's still in college. He's the top DJ right now. My other brother, military. And my younger brother, people don't know this, but if y'all thought 16 with 3 degrees is cool, he's 14 with 4 degrees.
Is he the one that was sitting beside you on Jennifer?
He sure was. He felt some type of way. He said, Shania, I don't like how you didn't allow me to say my part. Like, I ain't who I am. I said, I did, bro. Oh. I promise you.
I watched you was kind of dominant on that interview. You wanted the spotlight on yourself. You know, I understand that. That's Jay Hood. I get it. I understand.
It's Jay Hood, but bro was God. Like, hey. But no, his story went more viral than mine. It's just, I kept up with social media and he didn't have one. So I was like, man, people do not understand. I have a whole brother with 4 degrees.
What do you want people to know and take away from your story?
I want them to know, like, you can do anything you set your mind to. That's one of the mottos that my dad taught me at a very young age. Mm. And I set my mind to graduate at 13 years old, and I did it. So anything you put your mind to, you can do it as long as you put in the work that it that's taken to do it.
Right. That's right.
What I want people to know from my story, like I kind of mentioned, is the Invisible Black Scholar. We got a cheering section for our athletes. Let's create that cheering section for our scholars. And bringing about that inspiration, it's amazing. Being a teacher and literally my students walk around saying, my teacher is walking Black history. Mm. It touches me different.
I got you.
Yeah, right. So it's like, that's what I want people to go home with. You could do anything you set your mind to, but we are here to be seen. We are here so our voices can be heard.
It is, and you are seen.
I want to know what kind of prenatal pills your parents took while you was in the womb. Cause that, look, I think a lot of us use the Walmart brand. No, boy, that's crazy, man. Like God really did. He did that daggone thing with y'all. All y'all are smart. All of you guys are. And this is what we need to see in our community, that it's just not relied on a ball. It's just not relied on, you know what I'm saying, the athletics or whatever. You can use your brain to excel and go far, man.
Oh, absolutely. And I tell people this all the time. I say, if we put 1/10 of the same time, determination, the consistency that we do in sports, we would be 10 times farther in education. It's just the sports and the athletes, they got the cheering section. You don't hear no one cheering for the scholars. You don't hear no one. We ain't got all them people. We don't got the NILs for scholars. I'm like, why not? You know, we gonna be your next inventors, lawyers, doctors, presidents. What's going on? You feel what I'm saying?
Absolutely, so I feel you.
Understanding that dynamic, I'm like, something got to change, and it starts with me.
Right, and it starts with you, and you're actually doing it. And we appreciate you so much. I can't say that enough. I can't. I sit in class, and I look at my students, and I'm like, yeah, you guys are smart. But some of you guys, like the ones that are falling off, I just say, if I can just somehow, some way, get this projected to work so I can show them you, I mean, I know it can change because, you know, a lot of them come from, the hood, the ghetto, and what they see, and also the connection that they find on social media to enhance what they're already doing. It's like, that's not the way to go. They need to see positive. Yeah. So I don't know the neighborhoods that you grew up in, but where you did grow up, was it like helpful to where you're at now, or was it like, okay, just the norm, like, you know, is
it was honestly the norm. I didn't grow up anywhere special. I grew up in Eastside, Oklahoma, which would be considered the hood of Oklahoma City.
All right, cool.
Yeah, so I'm like real grounded in the roots. It's just, you know, always being that person whenever people see me, especially throughout the neighborhood, they like, hey, yo, that's family full of scholars. So we couldn't mess up in the neighborhood. People's gonna get up because they like, you way too smart for that. You feel what I'm saying? You don't got the same room to be messing up like everybody else because you actually got the resources to make it.
Right.
And so, we couldn't just act fools at the park. Our neighbors wasn't having that because they are young, like so many people so young. Like when we were young, saw our potentials today. And so it's so funny. It's like, Bear, we knew you was going to be this when you was a child. Like when you was 6, 7, riding your bike up and down my street, I knew what you was going to be. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's awesome. So to have a whole community backing you up like that, that is amazing.
Absolutely.
That's amazing. It's something that you said on an interview that really stuck out to me. And I think it was between a class change that I was having. It just like, I can't believe she said this. And it's something that I've said before, but you put it so perfect. You were saying that grades don't define you. Mm-mm. Your intelligence does.
Your intelligence
All does. You're doing is just memorizing something and putting it down on a piece of paper, and then we'll just grade it on your memory.
Right.
Can you explain that? Because a lot of children feel like they're not smart because they can't retain.
Right.
And put it to paper.
Right. So I explain it like this. So whenever I think of a grading system, let me tell you this. Real education don't have a grading system. There's no grade that flashes in the sky in life when you get the job or if you don't. You don't see an A if you do, and you don't see an F if you don't. You feel what I'm saying? But you're still learning. That's where what I call a true education comes in. So when we think about the systematic education, you have regurgitation and retaining information. That's all that is. So, hey, I taught you this. And the only like subject where that doesn't apply would be math, because math is formulas. So it's totally different. Right. But usually about 80%, you're going to get a lot of, hey, I told you this, or you read it, and cue you remember it on the test. What I call intelligence is the three levels of higher thinking, which is critical, analytical, and creative. So if you're able to analytically think, critically think, and creatively think, that's true intelligence, because you're not bounded by a book, a teacher, a grade, you know, a time period. It doesn't matter. You can do those three levels of thinking anywhere with anything. So it's totally different. So we grew up learning how to retain and regurgitate information to look good with our grades. But my parents also taught us the three levels of higher thinking, which was critical, analytical, and creative. So whenever I took my critical critical thinking class in college, I was like, this is a little different, because now they're trying to place this true intelligence class in a systematic way, and it doesn't work.
Right.
So it doesn't work. You feel what it doesn't fit.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of what I meant by that, is two totally different things, and we're blending them. So no, your intelligence and your ability to retain information, it's two different things.
Right. Exactly. Mm-hmm. That's amazing.
Yeah.
That's amazing. I clap on that, because I try to tell them that, look, you're not dumb. By a long shot.
This is right.
A lot of the stuff that you're seeing here, you're not going to even use it out there.
You're not. And I tell people this all the time. I was just at my homegirl's house, and she was showing me all her work. I said, baby, why they got you doing this?
Man, I tell you like this, man. It's like, listen, I apologize to the principals, the faculty, staff, and all like that. But you guys know that 92% of what you learned in high school in the 80s, 90s, and early 2000s, you're not using that not one time in the principal seat, the secretary seat, nothing. It's not working. It's just not, you know, but that's what they say that we got to have in order to pass and get this little piece of paper for a degree. But, you know, I just want kids to feel liberated, to feel like they are somebody. And a lot of parents, when they see those grades from the memory bank come in, and they start calling them names like, you're dumb, you ain't gonna never be nothing. It really, you know, I hear a lot of that at school, and it hurts.
Right.
Really breaks your heart. Yeah. All right. So you're a teacher, and I noticed that your class stands up. Y'all do a lot of innovative. Hey,
y'all get lit.
So do you think that is more effective with students versus them just sitting down all day?
Absolutely. I told my class on the first day, we won't be in these seats for long, because I don't like sitting down at all. Like, they'll tell me I'm going to sit down for 2 hours. I'm going to be hot. So I understand. I'm full 16. I understand certain things of the world. Y'all ate, and I know y'all don't like sitting down. And so being able to get up out your seat, express yourself, dance. Like, we usually do our fun little dances whenever we get a full, like, the whole class get 100s, or, you know, something big happened, or someone completed something major at home. It's like, I celebrate those things in my classroom. And so understanding how, like, man, when I come into class, I ain't going to be sitting down all day. Why you think people's favorite class was gym? Like, I've always been smart, but my favorite class was PE. I love Tuesdays and Thursdays, because that's when we got to go. So
That is amazing. That is amazing. So with you being 16 and a full-time teacher, prom, homecoming, those type of things, did you miss out on that?
I didn't miss out, because right now I'm class of 2025 when it comes to just regular high school years. So I really don't graduate till next year, which will be my prom year, and I am going to prom. So there has been like four schools that invited me out to their high school, and they say, hey, well, if you want to come to prom at our high school, you can. And I said, sure. So yeah.
Bing. Wait, so you're still in high school now? No,
I'm not.
Oh, so you're just saying, okay. I'm like,
okay.
Man, you got a lot going on. Okay, I got you. Got you. Okay, so the last question I have for you, knowing that you are walking Black history, knowing that you are inspiring a total different generation that we can't even imagine, knowing that you got parents that are older than you, but they still look up to you because of how you handle their children, what is your essence that you want to leave behind as you grow on your path?
Thing I really want to leave behind, and I tell a lot of people this, is have more faith in your success than you do your failures. We go into so many uncomfortable situations, and the first thing we think about is, what happens if I fail? What happens if things don't go right? What happens if I have a bad day and this doesn't go well? My thing is, step out with the confidence that you know you're going to win. You know, you have to make that decision first. The moment you wake up, you have to say, oh, I'm going to win today. I'm going to be successful. I'm gonna get the job. I'm going to get that grade. I'm going to go ahead and complete my to-do list. You have to lead with positive, like positive things. But we keep leading with these negative things and asking, man, why ain't nothing changing in my life? You feel what I'm saying?
Right,
so have more faith that you're going to succeed than having more faith that you're going to fail. So that's why
That is amazing. That's amazing. Oh boy, this is good. You're such an amazing person, man. That's so awesome.
Thank you.
I do have a couple of questions from people that knew I was going to have you on. They were like, oh my God, I want to ask you something. Okay.
So okay.
One asked your discipline to even do what you're doing. How hard is it to be so disciplined like you are?
At first it was hard. I ain't gonna hold you. I feel like anytime you're creating a new habit, the first 30 days get you. But right now it's easy because I know I'm living in my purpose. I mean, a lot of my success came from writing things down. Even from what I do today to my schedule, to understanding what I'm going to teach for today. It just came from writing things down. That's where the source of discipline comes from. You got to write it down. You got to see it first. And so I write everything down. I don't care if it's a thought I have in my head, my to-do list, it doesn't matter. Write it down.
Awesome. And the last one, I'm glad that they asked because I forgot to ask myself.
Uh-huh.
You got 3 degrees. You're going for more.
You're a
16-year-old teacher, the youngest teacher in the world. Yes. Mm-hmm. You're going to have a boyfriend one day.
I am.
Have they come to you now? And the type of boyfriend you're going to have has got to be he got to be a brainiac.
Yeah. Got to be made of Einstein or something.
Let's go. So how has, if you even are, have you been dating?
I have not. No.
All right. So that question.
Not official.
Not official. So we ain't going to let that happen until you 32.
Right. And so many people are like, I don't even want to see it, Shania.
Boy, that's crazy, man. Oh, my God. That's wild, because I'm telling you right now, bro, whoever you are, if you listen, you see this, you got to be on your P's, Q's.
Got to be on your P's and Q's. Absolutely.
Got to be. You can't play around with this one, bro. This one is a jewel. And, you know, they say with Cat Williams, when he did what he did on Shannon Sharp and all these other ones that just talk about goofy stuff. Oh, we got to protect this one. We got to protect that. No, these are the ones you have to protect.
Mm-hmm.
Because the enemy, social media, society wants to destroy this because this is powerful. This is what change is all about, guys.
Right.
So, Miss Shania Muhammad, thank you for being real Black history.
I appreciate it.
Thank you for applying your mind the right way and being who we wanted to be, but we didn't have support. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for doing it. Okay.
Of course.
Most definitely. So, I ain't got no $1,000 to give like Jennifer Hudson did, but what I will do, you teach third grade, right?
Mm hmm.
So what I'm going to do, your end of the year party, how many students you have?
I have 13.
13. So I'm going to throw you guys an end of the year party. Right. Yeah. So I'm going to cash app you or whatever like that. You'll get whatever you want. Y'all have fun. Have a party. I'm unmuted. Mr. Scott Simpkins. I'm unk now. Okay. I'm unk.
Okay.
So you better follow me back. You follow me back on Instagram. I'm unk. Okay. Comedian Scott Simpkins. I do comedy as well. So you do that. I'm going to take care of you guys. And also, I need your size and all this because I got new merch that I just released on Monday.
Awesome. Full
sweatsuit. It's my journey, not yours.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to need that. I'm about to be looking fly in class.
Yep. So whatever color you want, let me know your size and all like that. And I'll ship it to you free of charge.
All right. Thank you so much. Most
definitely. So you guys, hey, listen, hit her up on Instagram. She is amazing. She do talk back. Her lives are dope. Her information is dope. Please, please, please support this young Black woman. 16 years old, the youngest in the world. She was right here on Unmuted. Thank you guys so much. Like, comment, and share. Miss Muhammad, God bless you in everything. We will stay in touch. I got you. I got your back, okay? Straight up, God bless you. Peace. Everybody has their own path to take. Everybody has to play the cards dealt in life. Psalms 37 and 23 says, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. As a kid, I was taught right from wrong. Make the best choices. Always do good. But where I'm from, drugs, violence, death was the main course in this meal. Rest in peace, Omega.
I wasn't always the best kid. I didn't always do good. I didn't always make the right choices, but God had a plan. Whether I win, whether I lose, whether I'm up, whether I'm down, whether I succeed, or whether I fail, it's me versus me, baby. I'm gonna make it, and I hope you make it. But it's my journey, not yours. Unmuted. Peace. Thank you.